Hello everyone, one of the coaches at Unger Academy here, and today we're going to be showing you an approach that you can use to figure out the nature of a market in a quick and easy way. Now, in recent years, cryptocurrencies have acquired more and more importance, and as systematic traders, we've applied the same methods that we already use on major futures to study these new instruments. But what are the first steps to figuring out the structure and nature of a market? And above all, what do we mean by nature or behavior of a market? Well, let's go see it together. But before we start, if you haven't done it yet, I invite you to please go and subscribe to our channel and activate the bell to stay updated on the release of new videos. Hi, we are the Unger Academy, and we teach traders how to make money in the markets. Our founder, Andrea Unger, had been struggling with trading for years until he developed his automated trading method, which he used to become the only four-time world trading champion. Subscribe to our channel for free tips and tricks. So, a possible way to learn more about a market that you want to trade, so to understand the behavior of the instrument that you're going to analyze, could be to move back and forth on the one chart to figure out how the bars are configured. I immediately tell you that this isn't a good method, since it's highly inefficient and not very effective. As systematic traders, we like to test our ideas and possible strategies to see how they behave over time. In this video, we want to show you a very simple code that we generally use when we approach a market for the first time. So when we want to start trading a new underlying. The script we're now going to see is extremely simple and contains only two lines of code. So let's see them together. We're going to write buy next bar high stop and sell short next bar low stop, where sell short is the instruction to go short on an underlying. Now, these straightforward lines of code convey our intention to trade breakouts and, more in detail, to go long when the prices reach the highs of the previous day, because in this case, we're going to be using a daily time frame, and to go short when the prices touch the lows of the previous day. Now, let's go and see what happens on Bitcoin by compiling the strategy on the BTC USDT spot market. So we backtest the strategy on a historical series of data from about the beginning of 2017 until today. And we use a fixed dollar amount. In this case, it's about $10,000, which means that the counter value of our position will always be equivalent to $10,000. Now, let's take a look at the equity line we get by applying these two simple lines of code on a daily time frame. As you can see, this equity line is extremely positive. Now, both the short part and the long part produce good results. The fact that even the short part works, although not in an excellent way, may sound quite strange if you consider the fact that this market has always been rising over the years. So making some money with the short trades of a breakout strategy may not be that obvious. As for the long part, it's quite beautiful, and really these results are truly amazing. However, please keep in mind that this strategy, as it's written now, is not ready to be traded, because there could be some errors during the backtest, such as double entries in the same bar, for example. So this strategy should be considered a super preliminary analysis tool that helps us to understand if a market responds well to a breakout approach, like this one. Now let's go and see how to test a market with a reversal approach. To do this, we can simply use the same code we've just used, but replace stop orders with limit orders. So now we'll buy the next bar at the previous day's low with a limit order, and sell the next bar at the previous day's high with a limit order. Let's compile the strategy and see how it behaves on Bitcoin. Now, this is a strategy that could work quite well on a stock market or stock index, such as the mini S&P 500, for example. Okay, as you can see, this approach doesn't work on Bitcoin. It loses money on both the long side and the short side, so it would seem that Bitcoin is a trend-following market. That is a market that tends to rise when there is an uptrend, which means that it's more advantageous to buy on the highs and sell on the lows rather than doing the opposite. These two lines of code can be used to test all markets that you want. So let's go and try it on another market, Ethereum, for example, which at the moment is the second cryptocurrency by capitalization. Let's take our reversal strategy, so the one we've just coded using limit orders, and look at the results. And even in this case, we don't find anything interesting. So let's try and go back to the breakout strategy, so using stop orders instead of limit orders, and test it on Ethereum. Let's compile the strategy and see the results. Wow, okay, the performance are remarkable in this case too. Now, the strategy works very well on the long side. While on the short side, it seems to work a little bit worse than on Bitcoin, but still, it really works quite well and does make money. However, going short on this market quite often is not very effective. All right, so our analysis ends here. And we've seen the characteristics of these markets, Bitcoin and Ethereum, and we've seen that breakout approaches work very well in them since, well, they're definitely explosive, whereas mean-reverting logics don't work well at all in the medium to short term. We really hope that you found this video helpful, and if you have any questions that you'd like to ask, please write them in the comments. And if they're interesting, maybe we'll make some new videos based on them. If you want to learn more about the world of systematic trading, I invite you to go and click on the link that you're going to find in the description of this video. It'll take you to a completely free webinar in which Andrea Unger, the only four-time world trading champion with real money, will introduce you to this world, which is just so full of opportunities. And finally, if you haven't done it yet, please go and subscribe to our channel and click on the bell to stay updated on all our new content. And we'll see you in our next videos. And until then, bye-bye.